This is going to be a top 10 tobaccos of 2015. I saw that Smoking Pipeliner had done one. He only did a top 5, so I've got to better him by doing a top 10. It's as simple as that. There's only a reason why there's 10. Just about to fire up my brand new Matt Van Pipes Labatt and in it. I'll get to that shortly. Okay, this is in no particular order. I think that's a bit of a dodgy load. However, there's still smoke. In no particular order. These are all the tobaccos that I've gotten in 2015. No new ones. Put it this way. I either got them or I tried them. Okay, first and foremost. A blend that's only available in the month of October from Strauss Tobacconist in, I think it's Cincinnati. Something like that. You all know it. Some of you like it. Some of you hate it. Sleepy Hollow. I like it. It's an aromatic. Really good. Being from Australia, I don't know what pumpkin spice tastes like, but this is good, especially in the morning with coffee. Okay. And because we all love hard to get tobaccos, especially me, no people, it ain't Stonehaven. That's lawn fertilizer for the uninitiated. And I'm talking about a tobacco that's very, very high in quality. Really high in quality. No, it's not Penzance either. Although, that is a good smoke. I will say, that is a good smoke. It is made by the fine people from Orlick. And that is Richmond Navy Cut. Very similar to Orlick, except for no preak at all. Nada, nit, none. Just straight, bright, yummy, good Virginia. Just fantastic. Ugh, I'm getting chills just thinking about it. Next up, another fine product from Orlick. Dark Strong Kentucky. Tried that for the first time in Chicago this last year. Fell in love with the stuff. Even though I had a sinus infection and couldn't taste it, I still wanted to like it anyway. So, really good. Another blend that I tried at Chicago this last year. Didn't think much of it when I first tried it. But as so often happens, it's, taste buds change and, if there's someone out in their community that says it's really, really good, well, of course, naturally, you're going to like it. So this is one of those blends that everyone thought was the bee's knees, the duck's nuts, the shizzle and the mizzle. And, of course, I had to come around to like it, didn't I? Deception Pass by Seattle Pipe Club. Fantastic stuff. Really is. You need to give it a go. Really, really good. What I'm smoking right now. Tried the Bullseye Flake, tried the Luxury Twist Flake. Bullseye Flake's okay. Luxury Twist Flake is, it's not far off being lawn fertilizer, actually. For those who have taste. Peter Stockerby's Luxury Navy Flake. Fantastic stuff. Got this as a sample in Vegas. And the guy from Vegas took took pity on me, and he gave me the international sample, which was about 4 ounces. So so glad he did. This has become my go-to everyday Virginia. Really, really good stuff. I do plan on getting more of it and putting some away to sell it for a while because I can think it's only going to get better. Brilliant all day, kind of Virginia. One I tried when I very first got going into pipe smoking. and didn't like it. And in actual fact, it made my 2013 list of crap overrated or hard to get tobaccos. And that was Full Virginia Flake by Samuel Gawith. Retried it again in when I came over to Chicago. And so Metamorphosed, he actually gave me a little bit of 5 year old Full Virginia Flake to try, and I was like, wow, I'm blown away. This is just too freaking good. What the hell was I doing wrong? And as it turned out, I was doing nothing wrong. I just wasn't ready for it. Simple as that. Yeah, so that was that one. Next up, Dunhill Elizabethan mixture. Now, this tin happens to be 20 years old. So it's an unfair kind of inclusion. And this really should be an honourable mention. But I've also had fresh tins of it throughout the year. And really good. So excellent vapor. If you're into vapors, give it a go. You won't be disappointed. As a lot of people know, I'm nuts for McClellan's tobaccos. I really think they've got it. Especially with the Virginias. McClellan's Aurora, my go-to. Probably I smoke more of this than anything else that I've probably shown you already, apart from that Stockerby Navy Flake. I have literally lost count as to how many tins I've been through in the last 12 months. Probably somewhere in the vicinity of around about 6 to 7 tins of it, which for me is a lot. This one's just over a year old. And I've got more upstairs that is just sitting there quietly doing its thing. And I'll continue to let it do its thing. Fantastic. Red Virginia base, if you like Red Virginias. Black Stove Lemon Virginias. Fantastic. Awesome stuff. Something that was new to me that just really took me by surprise. Tried it in Vegas. That's where it was released. And it just, I don't know what it is. It just blew my mind. Predominantly not an aromatic guy. Mostly Virginias. And, well, this one just, I don't know. I just have no excuse. Occult Conspiracy. It's a good burley. It's a burley, predominantly burley. Has a kind of, what does it say here? Virginia's Black Cavendish Burley. And it says a hint of something else. Well, that something else is Latakia. Now, I was told this afternoon on a Skype call that apparently they can actually simulate the flavour of Latakia by using a spray-on. Didn't know that. I think this still does have the Latakia in it, just not a lot of it. It's a very, very muted background kind of thing. Vanillas, some honeys, caramels, little fruity thing going on. Get your hands on a tin and give it a go. There are other good tobaccos out there other than Colt Blood Red Moon. So, yeah, good stuff. Good stuff. And just for the smoking pipeliner, and I've left this one to last because it deserves such a prestigious little moment in time. And the only reason I'm not smoking it now is because I'm not smoking it now. GLP's Virginia Cream. Blended by Cornell and Deal. Now, this one to me is absolutely amazing because for the most part, I don't get along with Cornell and Deal. Again, this is GLP's recipe, and it's been executed by Cornell and Deal, which they generally tend to execute most other tobaccos. But just my opinion. This one, fantastic. Bourbon and vanilla. Kind of weird. Decent nicotine hit, but pretty much straight Virginias. It's kind of, it's just totally different. It's just not something that you'd expect out of Greg Pease's arsenal. it's quite unexpected. So give it a go. You're either going to love it or you're going to hate it. Don't try it on a corn cob. You're going to hate it. It just doesn't do well in a corn cob, in my opinion. It does well in briar, does okay in water. So, fantastic blend. Maybe one or two honourable mentions. Any list of mine, good, bad or indifferent, would be incomplete without Velvet. Possibly the best, absolutely the best pipe tobacco in the world. Really good. Good in a cob, good in mortar, good in briar, good in meerschaum, just good in anything. You put in a little incense burner and it'll just brighten up your life. It's just fantastic. Always a favourite for most people. The only reason why it didn't make my top 10 is because, well, it was right over the other side of the bench. And yeah, it's still quite good. Really, really good. This one happens to be a year old. A year on it. Doesn't do it any harm at all. In fact, it totally enhances it. So anyway, there's the all-important pipe nutter top 10 list for 2015. I know you're all going to sleep a whole lot better knowing that I finally made my list. And if I seem self-aggrandizing or self-important, then it's probably because I'm just in that kind of mood. No, I'm only kidding, guys. Just kidding. like the list, hate the list, doesn't really matter. It's just my list. If you've got a difference of opinion, then make a video and tell me all about it. Anyway, bugs are flying in now because this is the only light on in the shop. And, bugs don't do well in tobacco, so it's why I'm covering it up. Y'all take care. Cheers for now.